The Black Dragon. Today we're creating one of the most vicious animals known to man. Known to man's imagination. Yo, it's got these like dope green wings and purple spots, and it kinda looks like a knockoff of Maleficent. Missy Elephant. It looks a little bit like the Maleficent Dragon, doesn't it? I think this looks pretty cool, so let's get started. Now to create this black dragon, I'm using two egg-shaped cakes, a half 6-inch dome cake, and two 6-inch round cakes. Just leveled them off in their pans, except for the egg cakes. I leveled those off on the cutting board. Now I'm just using a box vanilla cake, but I added some blueberries, and yo, you guys, usually like my blueberries would sink to the bottom of my pan, but in the comments you told me to mix them with flour before I added them to the batter, and then they didn't do that. Oh, so good. Thank you, fist bump. Now to build my dragon, I needed a cake board with a little bit more support, so I drilled a hole into the middle of my 10-inch cake board, and then I hot glue gunned a PVC pipe into the middle. Now when the glue had hardened, I added buttercream and then inserted my first 6-inch round cake. In between each layer of cake, I'm adding on some buttercream frosting. And my next layer is my half dome cake. I'm just gonna add a pipe coupler to add a little bit more support for my dragon's head. It's gonna increase the area support by adding a small circle of cardboard. Then my first egg shape. Now for this to work, the larger piece of the egg-shaped cake goes by the PVC pipe and then the smaller side just hangs off the edge, right? I don't know how sturdy that is, but I built so many of these cakes and none of them have fallen off, so I think it's alright. I do want to give this a little bit more stability, so I'm adding some buttercream and then a longer piece of cardboard that's the egg shape. Now I'm cutting my PVC pipe down to be the perfect size, and then I added my second egg cake. Do you see it? Do you see like the makings of what will be a dragon? I see the black dragon, but I also see like a red dragon possibly, or like a gold one, or even like a unicorn. I'm pretty sure I could turn this into a unicorn. But I gotta wait though, because I've got like a whole bunch of like Halloween stuff, and then November is basically Christmas light, right? I mean, we totally just skipped Thanksgiving because the rest of the world doesn't even know what Thanksgiving is. And then a lot of people are complaining to me that the pilgrims actually pillaged the Indians, so Thanksgiving was actually a terrible holiday. This rant is like going on too long, so let's just get back to like the dragon cake. Now I gave my entire cake a crumb coat of buttercream, and then I placed it into the fridge to chill for about 3 hours? 4 hours, I think. I think I watched 4 episodes. While I was chilling, I was watching this show on Netflix called Greenleaf. Oh, Greenleaf is this Oprah-centric drama. So Greenleaf is this drama that airs on Oprah's network, and now it's on like Netflix. And it follows this extremely religious family who owns a mega church somewhere in the South. It focuses on like the drama of the family and like the power struggle, because there's this new church that's trying to step on everybody's toes, and they're not having it. It's not the best show I've ever seen. I just think it's like super juicy, which is why I like to watch it. So if you have Netflix and you're looking for a show, check it out. Now after my buttercream stiffened up, I took my serrated knife and began to create my dragon shape. I wanted his snout to be a little bit more narrow, and then I wanted to make it so that his head at the back wasn't as rounded. Now if you watch a lot of my videos, and you know that I used this exact shape to create my baby raptor blue cake. I created the beta raptor from Jurassic World. Did you guys watch the second movie? It was alright. I mean, it made me really sad. Now it's a pretty awesome cake, but I didn't do much carving and shaping to the head, but I wanted to make sure that my dragon cake had a little more detail. Now just like my velociraptor, I used my knife to create my dragon's neck, and then I separated the back legs from the rest of the body. Now I used my second 6-inch cake to create my dragon's tail, and I didn't actually use too much of it because the tail is so small. So you can use like cake scraps, or you can even just use Rice Krispies treats if you have some on hand. Now after I was happy with my cake shape, gave my entire cake another crumb coat, placed it into the fridge to chill, took it out, and gave it a full coat of green buttercream. I knew that some of the details on the finished product were gonna be green, so I thought it'd be cool to have like a whole green cake underneath the fondant. It doesn't actually matter though, so just, you could just skip this. After I covered my entire cake with buttercream, I wasn't happy with all of the details I carved out, so I carved out some more. Thinned out his snout some more so that it would look longer. And I kind of shortened where his thighs would be because I wanted his front legs to be longer. So instead of this dragon only walking on its hind legs, it would actually be walking on all fours. Now I got lazy and I didn't cover it with a chrome coat. I just went straight into my green coat of buttercream. Now I placed it back to the fridge, I watched like two more episodes of Greenleaf. Then I started to cover my entire cake with fondant. Now I paneled some black fondant onto each side of my dragon's body. I just cut away the excess fondant by the neck and then used some sculpting tools to blend the fondant into the buttercream. And I used more sculpting tools at the bottom and just pushed the fondant into the cake board. Then I cut away the excess. And I placed some green fondant on the bottom of my dragon's mouth and also a piece that just covered his belly and the front of his neck. I wanted them to like look like a snake, so I'm just using my veining tool to give them some line details. I covered my dragon head with a single piece of black fondant and I just worked the fondant down the head, but I didn't actually have to like worry about the bottom because I knew that the green that like covers his bottom lip would be exposed. So just cut away the excess fondant, expose the green fondant underneath. I couldn't believe that this was coming out as well as it did because black fondant, I think it's like the hardest fondant to work with because it cracks so easily. But I just worked as fast as I could and it didn't crack at all. Now I covered my dragon's tail with a large piece of black fondant and then just blended it into the rest of the cake. Cut away the excess and with a sculpting tool, I just added some defining lines to emphasize his cheekbones and make sure that there were like large indentations where I could put his eyes. Then I placed my cake back into the fridge and I started to work on all my dragon details. Now for all my dragon details, I added CMC so that the fondant would get really hard and it wouldn't like flop over on my cake. Created dragon teeth with white fondant that I cut into triangles. And then I created this template so I could create some dragon scales. I wanted to be like spikes on my dragon's head and body. And I'm using some sculpting tools to add some defining lines and give this scale some character. And then I inserted a dowel into the larger one and toothpicks into the smaller ones. That way I can just plunge them into my cake. Now to create my dragon's back legs, I started with circles of black fondant and I just like smashed them down a little bit to create three toes. Three toes for each leg. Now for my front legs, I rolled a large piece of black fondant into a log and then I just used my hand to push down the front and create some paws and just used some sculpting tools to create some dragon toes. Now you're gonna need two of these. Now with some white fondant, I created some dragon claws. Back, I just created three large triangles. And then for the front, I created some really small thin claws. Now I rolled out some green fondant to create his wings. And I just made it so that one side of the fondant was super thick so that I could insert dowels into it. Now his wings almost like an arrowhead shape. And I just used some veining tools to give it some wing detail. Texture. And I just repeated this process to get the second wing. Didn't want these to be flat, so I pushed them up against each other and so that they would have a bend. And I took my cake out of the fridge and started applying all of my dragon's features. First, I added the toes to the back legs, and then I attached the front legs with some magic sauce to hold them in place. Now, the larger teeth I applied to the front of the snout. And then I placed some smaller teeth at the back. And then I applied two fondant eyes. Now I wanted to give these eyes a little bit of detail, so I added some purple spots to make him look a little more menacing. And then I added all of my dragon scales. I just placed like really small ones up front by his snout. And then I just made them increasingly larger as I worked my way to the back of the dragon head. And they just got progressively smaller as I worked my way down the bottom of his tail. I shot this cake like 4 months ago, you can tell, because my like backdrop has like changed so much. But when I was looking at the footage again, I was still really impressed. It looks pretty bomb. And I wanted my dragon's eyes to be glowing, so I mixed a little bit of yellow and green food coloring with some vodka and just painted them onto the rim of my dragon's eye. I'm just gonna blend this into the rest of the white eye to achieve the glowing effect. And I plunged in my dragon wings. And I didn't want him to be just like standing on a cake board, so I'm adding some, you guessed it, coconut shavings. I just dyed them gray with a little bit of black food coloring and some vodka. So it kind of looks like he's stepping on the ashes of like his enemies. Yes, and voila, my black dragon was complete. This guy looks so sick. I love all the details. I love the green on his bottom lip. I love the purple detail around his eyes. You know, they're very small, but they actually really add a very big impact. I love his dragon wings and I love the way that his eyes glow. I think that looks really nice. If you want to see more animal cakes, there's an entire playlist for you in the description box. Make sure you check out my dinosaur cake. That looks really cool, even though I didn't like the second movie. It's just so sad. So a few months back, California had all of these wildfires and my like Instagram feed was being flooded by all of these animals running down the mountain trying to escape the fire. And so it's gonna make me so sad. When I was watching Jurassic World 2 and all of those dinosaurs were jumping into the water to escape the volcano, it reminded me of that and I was crying. Why did they do that? They killed my childhood. That's why I didn't like the movie. Did you like it or did you have problems with it? Oh my god, I want to roll my eyes like 40 times because of that movie. And I hope you guys enjoyed this. I love you. I will see you very soon. Peace.